Hey, yo, brothers, how y'all doing? What's y'all name, man? Y'all come close, check these signs out. This brother T right here, this y'all brother right here, man. I'm brother Michael, all right? I want y'all to look at these signs. Y'all come in. Y'all check this out right here. We showing our people who they are according to the Bible. You're God's chosen people. Look at this sign right here. This is what God calls his people. These are the bywords that the world called us. What do y'all see yourself on this sign? How you doing, brother? What's your name?
Brother Kev,
check this out. What do you see your name on this sign right here? This is very important. This is very important for you to know. Go back to Isaiah chapter 1. Where y'all see yourself at? Tribe of Judah, Benjamin, Levi, Judah. What about you, young brothers?
Judah.
All right. Watch this. No, matter of fact, give me that in Hebrews. That Christ came from the tribe of Judah. And I'm going to show you the description of Christ as well. Watch this. Give me that in Hebrews. I'm going to show you what tribe Christ came from. It said it's evident that Christ came from this tribe. Why? Because if Christ came from this tribe, obviously his people look just like him. Watch this. Look at all these brothers you see around you. One look too different from you. It's other pink people out here that look way different from you.
Right.
Watch this. Hebrews chapter 7. Come on. We're going to show you that thus saith the Lord according to the Bible. The scripture is evident. Scripture 12. Come on. You got it? We're going to show you this in the Bible. Read what you got. 7 to 12. Okay, look at that picture right there. We're going to bring that description out for you too. Read. This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 7, verse 14. For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood. The scripture said it's evident that Christ came from the tribe of Judah. Watch this. Let's get a description of Christ in Revelations. Revelation chapter 1. Let's start at verse 14. Hey, young brothers, look at this picture right here. What parts of the one would you think Christ is? Before we read this, which one you think is Christ? Which one? The King of Kings. All praise to the Most High. We're going to show you that, thus saith the Lord. Watch this. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool. You see that brother behind you? So did y'all raise your hand up. You see that brother got white and woolly hair, right? Read. As white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire. What up, brother, go in. Brother T, come here, bro. And you too, I know y'all too young to drink. Brother, Brother Kevin, when you drink a little, what color your eyes turn? The white part. What color it turn?
Red.
Little red. Brother T, you drink? You know?
Smoke them.
You need to put that cigarette there, but we just went over that, brother. That's an unclean thing, you're destroying your body. But you gotta clean yourself up, man. The Lord can't use you and dwell in you, brother, you destroying your body with cigarette smoke. We just brought that out to you. You gotta put that thing away, man. You gotta repent. You gotta come back to God's laws, bro. These young men right here, they need good examples. I don't live in this community right here. But obviously, I see y'all going to these stores. Y'all live in this community. Y'all gotta be good examples to these young brothers. And they see y'all upholding the law. They see y'all taking care of your wives and your children. These young men gonna follow that example.
That's right.
But if we out here acting like niggas, sleeping with multiple women, smoking cigars and cigarette and weed smoke, shooting up there, that's what they gonna do. That's what they gonna follow. These not the ones on TV doing that. It's the older people that's on TV doing that. Read what you got. And his feet like unto fine brass. Hey brother, what y'all feet the same? Y'all feet the same color as your body? Maybe a little lighter when it comes to the shoes, right? But it's the same color as your whole body. Read. As if they burn in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters. See, this is the problem with our community right now. Women do not know how to keep their mouth shut when the men of the Lord are speaking. When we bring out God's laws, women have to shut their mouth. The scripture says they're commanded to remain silent in the church, because nothing but foolishness comes out of the black woman's mouth. The men are the priests. Give me that in the scripture. The priest's lips should keep knowledge. And that's talking about the men. The priesthood was given to the men, not to the loudmouth, wicked black women that's only bringing death and destruction to the community. Those are the ones that's running our churches, teaching lies. Those are the ones raising our young men to grow up being feminine, and they become so damn emotional, they start killing each other. Y'all die by the hands by your own brothers because they so emotional and effeminate like a damn woman. That's the problem with our people. Read what you got.
Isaiah 3 and
12. Listen, read. The book of Malachi, chapter 2, verse 7.
Come on.
For the priest's lips should keep knowledge, and they should seek the law at his mouth. The priest, give me Isaiah 3:12. The priest's lips should keep knowledge. The priests are the men. nothing like no black woman.
That's right.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Brother, tell me something. How many people in our community have been gunned down by the loudmouth lying black woman? How many? Countless. Countless. You can't even count. Oh, he pushed me. Next thing you know, another brother come out there to shoot another brother down. These loudmouth women, they always bring death to our communities. They the main ones having abortions, bringing death to our community. Read what you got. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 3, verse 12. As for my people, children are their oppressors. As for our people, children are their oppressors. The young folk, the young men and women, read. And women rule over them.
And who?
Women rule over them. It's these wicked women that's raising effeminate men. It's these wicked women that's raising wretched ass young females, cracking their legs open to every nigga and ride they see.
That's right.
Pilling their mouth open to every ride they see.
That's right.
They're like thirsty travelers. Man, get that for me, SWAT 25.
You know,
I'm sick of these wicked ass women running their mouth, destroying our community.
Bring it up.
Next thing you know, it's the next one of them will be pregnant and they're going to be in the abortion line. And let's see what BLM at there. Let's see what Black Lives Matter at there. And one of these young girls not to be pregnant, standing in the abortion line, getting their lives cracked open and crushed and destroyed. They won't be there. That's the problem with our people today. You so-called blacks and Hispanic men, you need to wake up. Take back your community. That's the problem today. Read what you got. This is the book of Sirach, chapter 26, verse 12.
These are young women today. Read.
She will open her mouth as a thirsty traveler. These young women, they loved by these older women, open their mouth like a what? As a thirsty traveler, swallowing up every nut they can come across.
That's right.
That's what they doing.
Bring it up.
This is the Bible we read. This is God's words. Read. When he hath found a fountain,
come on,
and drink of every water near her, and drink of every water near her. Any brother she can wrap her lips around, she on her like a flower of shit. Read.
That's right.
And drink of every water near her. By every hedge will she sit down, and open her quiver.
Over the what?
Open her quiver.
And with any man she could come across, she crack them legs open and let him do what he do.
Read. And open her quiver against every arrow.
Against what?
Every arrow.
Her arrow is what?
That thing's stiff and straight, ready to go to war.
That's right.
And these women land with every last one of these men. But that's what our women are teaching these young girls today. The Cardi B's and the other young girl's name?
Megan the Man.
Megan the Man and all them people.
That's right.
That's what they teaching our young girls.
That's right.
Teaching them to grow up to be thirsty travelers. But us, the so-called black men, Hispanic man, repentant man, we come to teach our daughters how to live righteous.
That's right.
Read. Verse 25. A shameless woman shall be counted as a dog.
A what?
A dog. Who cares about a dog, man? The Lord said a shameless woman should be counted as a dog. But what are we going to teach our daughters? Give me 1 Timothy chapter 2. This is what the repentant man teaches his daughters. We teach them how to live righteously. We teach them how to be silent when they're amongst men. Not making yourselves equal to them. Hey, how you doing, brother? What's your name?
How you doing, sir?
What's your name, brother?
My name is Otis Wilkins.
Brother Wilkins?
Yes, sir.
Brother Otis, we ain't gonna worry about your last name, because your real last name is Israel.
That's
right. Otis, we talk to our brothers, man. We showing them these women out here, these young girls, they wicked as hell. So the black man, the Hispanic man, the Native American man, we gotta take our communities back. We gotta take our rightful place in God's kingdom. We gotta guide our people. We gotta teach our young men, we gotta teach our young daughters how to live righteously, keeping God's laws. Read.
Let me 1 Timothy 2 and 9. Yep, 1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 9. We gotta show our people that we gotta put out their iniquity. Because we're so messed up in our communities.
The reason we're so messed up, because we don't know who we are. Read. The book of 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 9. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel. How do our women dress today? Brothers, how do our women dress today? They don't leave, God, like what?
Like
they don't leave nothing to the imagination, do they? So how can I tell a righteous woman apart from an unrighteous woman? Because these sisters that you call them a hoe, they're like, I ain't no hoe, I'm not a hoe. How can I tell? Look how you dress.
Right.
Titties all out, ass all out, your private all out. How can I tell you a hoe or not? You weren't underwear in public. When we grew up, leggings was what? Pantyhose. Those were underwear.
That's right. Yeah.
That's what they wear in public. You go to the beach, they wear bikinis. No, that's underwear. That's bra and panties.
That's
The texture don't make no difference. That's underwear. Agree what you got. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel, with shamefacedness. That modest apparel covering your body up, not exposing yourself for every Tom, Dick, and Harry to see you. You're not leaving anything to the imagination. That's modest apparel, a long, flowing, pretty dress, like a princess of God you should be. If you brothers are married, got sisters, aunties, cousins, mothers, grandmothers, I don't want anybody to disrespect. I know y'all don't want nobody disrespecting them. And I know y'all don't want anybody disrespecting them. I don't want anybody disrespecting them. Because they my people too. Our people are looked at as sex objects in this world, man. Our women in other countries, look at it online. They're looking at it as sex objects. They walk the street, even dress modestly, but what they see on TV is the black woman, the Hispanic woman, is portrayed as a whore. So when they go to different places around the world, people hollering at them, hooting and hollering and whistling at them. No, God says they have to dress in modest apparel and be shamefaced.
We used to scream black power while Harem was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.